Do you think it's going to take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
I could go for a little Larry time right about now. I gotta see Captain Perry. Orders are orders. Gee, I hate internal politics bullshit. Let's get the formalities out of the way so I can get back to some real work. God, I'm bored. I hate having nothing to do.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. I'll cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain. Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get him right together. You know how to tie a knot in a necktie.
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press are all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No, of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Well, I hope you're better at profiling than at tying knots. Ah, oh, forget it, I'll manage. Oh, go see Charlie and she'll show you to your office. Check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
I saw Blake when I arrived. Maybe I should go talk to him.
The body of Jeremy Bowles was found this morning on a patch of wasteland in the East End at about 6:30 a.m., 5 days after he was reported missing. An autopsy will be conducted tomorrow to determine the exact cause of death, but going from first indications, it would seem that he drowned. The state in which the body was found suggests the methodology of the origami killer. The investigation should confirm this in the coming days. The police are continuing to work around the clock to find the murderer as quickly as possible. I'll field some questions. Yes.
You said the methodology indicated another victim for the origami killer. Can you be more specific?
An origami figure was found in the victim's hand, and an orchid was placed on his chest. His face was covered with mud, but there were no visible traces of violence to the body. Go ahead.
The Zodiac killer was never identified. Perhaps the origami killer would never be found either.
I don't think there's much chance of that. For the moment, the killer may think he's invulnerable, but in the end, he'll make a mistake and we'll be there to arrest him. Yes?
Did the killer leave any written evidence? Perhaps a ransom note explaining his actions, or anything like that?
No. He has not made contact in any way, and we have only the murders to help us understand his motives. Yes? What's the question?
Some people are saying that the police were slow to take an interest in these murders because the victims lived in poorer parts of the city. What do you say to that?
That's absurd. The police make no distinctions between victims based on their social class. It is true that the origami killer seems to choose his victims from the more impoverished parts of town. The higher crime rate in these areas makes the investigation more difficult. Time for a couple more. Yes.
There are rumors that the FBI has sent a profiler to help with the investigation. Is that true?
You seem to be well informed. Yes, we asked the FBI to send us a profiler to help us with this investigation. We were planning to announce this in the next few days, but it seems that won't be necessary.
According to certain sources, the town hall has been applying pressure to avoid any mention of a serial killer in order not to have an adverse effect on the mayor's election campaign. Do you have anything to say about that?
Pure speculation. At no time has the mayor been involved in this investigation, except to support the efforts of the police force, of course. Thank you for your cooperation.
One question, please, sir. One last question.
Captain Perry, one more question, please.
This investigation is starting to give me the creeps. Get a hold of yourself, man. Case is front page news in all the papers. It's not going to be easy investigating the crime under the glare of all this publicity. I should get Perry's assistant to show me my office. I can't wait to get to work. I'm dying of thirst. Where's the water cooler when you need one? Strange character, Captain Perry. Seems to be more interested in meeting the press than investigating the crime. I'll have a look around the station. Stretch my legs for a bit.
I'm ready to start. Maybe we should kick off by talking about the case?
I have some work to finish here. Let's talk about that later, if you don't mind.
Okay. No problem. Just let me know when you're available.
Really starting to dislike that guy. Better watch my back from now on.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work. Wow, more like a big cupboard. Well, I wanted a quiet place to work, and it certainly looks like I got it. No time to lose. Gotta get down to work. First, analyze the case files.
Step one, change the office. The killer's car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83. prints or specific clues. Nothing much to go on. Just one origami store in town. A common species. That doesn't help much. The orchid is a common species. It can be found at any flower shop. Eight victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall. The killer has a large comfort zone. He gained confidence rapidly and moved away from his base. This won't make the geoprofiling any easier. Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on. Wash my face. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. It's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it. The bathroom. I need to find a safe place. Don't break down. I can do without it. I can do without it. I need it. I'll feel better. Here we go again. I better go wash my face. I gotta hang on. I can beat this. Oh, I feel like crap. I gotta have it. I gotta, just this once.
No one
will see.
Thank you.
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marsh. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while, and then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses, and when I turned back, Sean had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Mars. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about... Yeah, that's it, 4:15. I remember exactly because I looked at the clock in the park when we arrived.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. A beige coat. And a pair of pants. Green pants.
How could Sean have disappeared without you even noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I went to sit on a bench a little way off. I didn't notice right away the carousel had stopped. That must have been when Sean disappeared.
You say you took your son to the park after school, but you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
Did Sean have any particular difficulties, Mr. Morris? Anything that might have caused him to run away?
Sean is a sensitive child. Our relationship has been a little difficult recently.
Everything okay at school? Any particular problems between you and your wife?
My wife and I have been separated for the last 6 months. But Sean would not have gone off without telling his mother or me.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Do you think the origami killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple of hours.
But what if it is the origami killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Find something?
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
It's still too early to say, but it is a possibility.
Strong like that. You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? Sorry. It's not what I meant to say.
Good evening to you, sir. Guy behind the counter? Gotta suppose that's him. Store's empty. Guess it's that time of day. Well, it's a good time for a quiet little talk.
Can I help you, sir?
Well, I hope so. My name's Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
My son is dead, Mr. Shelby. I have nothing more to say.
The killer has kidnapped another victim. A 10-year-old boy. Like your son, Risa. I have 4 days before we find his body on a deserted stretch of wasteland.
No one did anything to save my son. Now, please, to move along, sir.
I also lost someone I loved. I know what you're feeling.
Then you will understand that I do not wish to talk about it.
Oh, do you sell inhalers? I'm all out and... at least I won't go away completely empty-handed.
In the back of this store, to the right.
Thanks. Pity he didn't want to talk. Might have known something. Goddamn asthma. Can't breathe when it rains.
Good evening, sir. Are you looking for something in particular?
Give me what you got in the register. Don't fucking try anything. Open the register, you dumb fuck. Put the money on the counter. Shit, are you deaf or what?
A young guy, and he's on, and he looks nervous. Things are gonna get out of hand if I don't do something.
Very hard.
Better not move. Kid might panic if I try anything.
What did you say? You're out of your fucking mind, man. You don't get it, do you? I'm gonna put the fucking bullet right between your eyes if you don't do what I say now.
Wait.
I'll not be robbing my register.
Wait for it.
That money is mine.
Let's turn the other way.
To leave before it is too late.
What's his problem?
Open your register.
Goddamn principles. Always said they were a waste of time.
No, sir. That I cannot do.
He hasn't seen me yet.
I'll waste you, man.
Still got a chance.
I swear to God, man, I'll blow your fucking brains out! Fuck! Fuck! The goddamn thing is locked!
Sam's gonna get whacked if I don't do something fast. Punk. Didn't give me any choice.
1,000 thank you, sir. I don't know what would have happened if you had not been here.
Well, at least I didn't come by for nothing. Have a nice day.
When my boy, Reza, disappeared, I received a letter with a locker ticket inside. Inside the locker, I found this box. I do not understand what it means, but I think it must be a sort of message from the man who took my son from me.
Can I?
take the box if it can be of any use to you at all. It did not help me to save Reza, but maybe it will help you find the other little boy.
Mr. Shelby.
I was beginning to think that there was no good to be found in this place. I can see now that I am